What looks like very much their strongest lineup. Edwin Cocker there. He's got power, and Raikambula as well. Real forceful players. Hunt the playmaker, the pace of Pelanice and Zaha Lawrence. And this is Tunisia. Well, they are a side who are amongst those who are improving year on year. A week ago, they beat Argentina, and that caused a shock on the opening day. They've already created one this time, beating Australia 21-12. Watch out for Kafani and Zegden, both very clever players. Well, we're getting on the way to Christmas, aren't we? And it's holiday time here in South Africa. The schools are out, and sadly the rain is in. And here come the two sides, the whites of Tunisia in their third season of IRB Sevens, and they're in the black. The formidable team who, as New Zealand, have won six of the seven IRB World Series seasons so far. Displaced, though, by Fiji last season. First time someone else had topped the overall championship other than New Zealand. They want it back, do New Zealand. England's Bruce Robertson here is in charge of this game. 7 minutes each way. Handling, believe me, will not be that easy, but then these sides were used to even significantly worse conditions in Dubai a week ago. So they wait. And what essentially has all the makings of a pool decider, with Australia already having been beaten. And Tunisia will not be a complete pushover, I'm quite sure of that. But this is a formidable strength up front that New Zealand have. Lotte Raikambula there setting it up, and Lawrence, they've got pace too, Lawrence and Pelanice. Here is Solomon King, just 21, fresh out of the Rugby World Cup 21 age group. On the side. And the one thing Tunisia cannot afford is to give away ball to these players in black. They need to be at their very, very best, Tunisia, to have a realistic chance of creating a massive upset. But Sevens has a habit of throwing them up now and again. Right. Down goes Edwin Cocker. Right. Burly, hard man. Right. Not yet hands on ball. Displaced there, went backwards, picked up by Abbas Kafani. Kafani opts to stand firm and try and take out a couple. Bellanice and Lawrence. Turnover ball, New Zealand, and Cocker sets it away to Raikambula. It's Nigel Hunt, good distributor. Here is Pelanice, can't make it himself, but the pass goes to ground from Cocker. It's a knock-on anyway. And you can't really see it on the screen, but the ball will be very, very greasy. We have a sort of a pretty persistent drizzle at the moment. But there's going to be a change of decision here. I think there will be a penalty to New Zealand. A late tackle by Saifedini Hussuna. So an error that's cost Tunisia dear here. Gives New Zealand free ball. Let's have a look at the number 11. Well, didn't stand out very much, did it? There we go. This is Lawrence, though. Here is Raikambula. Can go himself, big handoff, big drive to the line, and the opening score. Well, that's a little harsh, I have to say, on Tunisia. But relief all round. And something to settle New Zealand nerves. Side who beat Fiji in the semi-final in Dubai a week ago, then that epic final. New Zealand went 12-0 up before the Springboks turned the tables in the final, and how. Five tries unanswered in that second half. Terrific kick with Hunt adding the points. Very useful to have a consistent goalkeeper of this quality. So Lotte Raikambula from Hawke's Bay, who's one of those players that Gordon Tietjens just found playing in a park in a local club. Said, come on board and let's see what you're like. We'll give you some training. He ended up in the training camp last season. Next thing, he was in an all black or New Zealand Sevens jersey. Thank you. not an easy defence to breach. Hamami held there, and see how quickly New Zealand closed down the opponents. Just keep them under persistent pressure. And that's how they played it against South Africa in the first half of the final last week, before the Springboks changed the game plan. And just kept the ball moving. There's Gordon Tietjens looking on with Ross Everest, the manager. Zar Lawrence, Raikambula again. Nigel Hunt, oh, great acceleration, running on the arc, good angle, try number two. It was quite interesting just looking at Gordon Tietjens just now, because I watched him after their opening game against Scotland. And far from going back to the player changing room with the team, he stayed out and watched Tunisia in their game against Australia, because he knew, of course, that Tunisia and Australia were the two other opponents for New Zealand. He does his homework, he does the detail. This was neat, taken at pace, and just that momentum really took him through the tackle. Another good conversion, it's 14-0, Hunt. Well, he's having a terrific opening to this season here in George, last week in Dubai. Certainly the player of the team. And they're all sorts of trouble here. Tunisia on the wrong side of the ball, and they've just been out-muscled, out-thought. DJ Forbes, the captain. That's his first try. He's normally the try creator, not the scorer, but that's his first of this season. The new captain of New Zealand. So they've quickly taken control and Hunt unerring in the conversions. Just the handoff, no particular pace, but upper body strength and a direct route to the goal line. And as ever, around the world you'll always find New Zealand supporters. Tunisia not in the hunt at the moment. Hamami. Well, seemed a bit too keen to run into contact. Change of tactic here, though. Mohamed Zayed Khalili. Cross comes Hunt. A clever little runner. Perhaps not the pace of Stefan Basson, but useful operator. Raikambula. Dummies to Lawrence. Pelanis outside. Inside now. Bit slow to take off. Zegden in with the tackle.
Not forward.
Went forward. So the last few seconds of the first half. Like a sea fret, really, that's come over the ground here. This awkward drizzle. Well, don't kick it to the opposition. That's what they've done. And All Blacks will thrive on that sort of thing. Raikambula, 1-2, men beaten. Finally took two more to hold him. Lawrence under pressure. But there's a penalty here, offside. Tunisia in desperate defence. Scarce been out of their own half since the whistle started the game. Nigel Hunt from Wellington. There you go. Puts them through, and Edwin Cocker dives, doesn't ground it cleanly. Clever change of tactic, no try, but half-time it is, and New Zealand, well, very authoritative, very much in control, 21-0. It was a clever idea, saw that Tunisia were up, a little chip through, and just Cocker's mistake, the kick was fine. And they'll settle for that. New Zealand comfortably placed. Tunisia, no sign of a fairy tale double here, with Australia already beaten. Gordon Tietjens never content, but perhaps that's a sign of a top coach.
Always
to seeks to improve.
Let's see. Let's see.
Goes out, just gives. I need to score straight away. Then I brings up the old guys off the bench, eh? First one.
Brothers, don't rest on this. Empty the tank, bro.
21 could easily have been 28. Here's the dive. And it's a good call. You can see he didn't get any downward pressure, any control of the ball. And it stayed then at 21-0. Yeah, well, that tells a story. We saw it after what happened in Dubai. We'd be blessed with sunshine here, but we have had earlier in the week, but now it's drizzle, but it's not the water splash that we had in the desert a week ago. Mohamed Sayroui, no doubt happy with the win over Oz early on. But still with ambitions, of course, a victory over Scotland, barring a dramatic upset in the other games, would certainly assure Tunisia still of a place in the Cup quarterfinals, which would be no mean achievement. And Tunisia have Scotland, that will be a decisive encounter. That being on the assumption, which one should never make, that Australia will beat New Zealand, or the other way around. And white. Zegden, the white of Tunisia. Well, that's crossing. Pretty obviously, Nasreddine Hammami. Exactly what Tunisia didn't want, New Zealand did. And you probably may have heard Gordon Tichin saying, let's have a try right at the start of the second half. You wouldn't bet against it. Here's Nigel Hunt. Not the best pass to Rai Kambula. Could be 2-1 out wide, depends how to use it. DJ Forbes, bit too readily signposted that, and they've not going to got possession there because Pelonis has thrown forward. That was a bit laboured, and you can see he didn't think much of that, did he?
Come on, let's speed it up, please.
It's Pelonis. Alfred Pelonis from Canterbury, product of the 19 groups. He plays
engage.
Well, sometimes wide, sometimes sweeper. Away come Tunisia. But that's not the best way to pass it, is it? Straight to Edwin Cocker, who says, thank you very much. And Gordon Teachers has got that early second half try he wanted. Well, you can't say that their shirts were confusing. There's not much in the way of excuse for this. Edwin Cocker. Another try. Dear, oh dear. Probably got misdirected by the hand on his arm, which gave a gift to Edwin Cocker and the Otago man. No problem. Missed conversion attempt by Nigel Hunt. But you have to say New Zealand absolutely secure now. Oh dear, that's cruel. As if it wasn't hard enough anyway. We have a game continuing if they had the... now we've got two of them. Bruce Robertson then, and the restart with just the one ball. Not a bad option here. Until Hunt, you see, he's knocked it on. It's a slippery pill down there, and it's a knock on that gives Tunisia at least a chance of possession again.
From my left, thank you. Right, Carton, I'll engage. Right.
Well, that's awkward. On the retreat and stolen, ripped out by Lawrence.
Rack.
Nigel Hunt. Doing the graft. They're very versatile and they're very fit. It's a strict regime that Gordon Tichins imposes.
Rock! Rock!
those awful bleep tests and things like that.
Rasmussen, ruck!
They make them fit. And Tunisia, look, a little shell-shocked here, that early onslaught. Last quarter of the game. Right, Kambula, though. And good tackles coming in. Halaili.
Number three,
and Hamami. Solomon King on not releasing. This is just a matter of self-discipline. It's hard, I know, but you don't want to release the ball if you know you haven't got teammates and support, but better that than give away the penalty. This is Cocker. Advantage over. Cocker just toying with the defence at the moment. Now he's on a straight drive. Big tackle by Saifedean Hassouna, but as ever, New Zealand masters of the backup. And the support of Zaha Lawrence brings him the reward of the try. Whether, of course, New Zealand have the pace, the sheer exceptional pace of South Africa and Fiji is a question that will be answered, I'm sure, before this day is through. That might be their Achilles heel. Quick, but not exceptionally quick. But sometimes you don't need the pace, you just need a big bruiser charging up the middle, ducking and diving, and then saying, well, OK, I'll upload it to you, you can run it in. 33-0. A couple of minutes remain. Tunisia without any consolation points even, having, well, let's hope they didn't do their sort of best day's work in beating Australia. Australia, a makeshift side. After a row of remuneration and players saying not enough money, they were told, well, you're not involved in the, if you don't wear the Wallaby shirt, then don't come. Then they changed their minds, by which time Glenn Eller had gone ahead and picked a shadow side of those who weren't protesting. So they've done exceptionally well, notably in beating winning in Dubai against Fiji, which really was quite extraordinary, with a completely fresh side, barring Tim Atkinson, their captain. The other 11 never played RB Sevens before. What do they do? Go and beat the world champions in the pool in Dubai. No points here, though, for Tunisia. Desperately trying to retain some possession, but not really getting a line abreast. And now New Zealand just drift across and then drift back. But it's just a bit more like it from Tunisia until then.
Knock over here.
Last 30 seconds. Little's gone right for them here. Replacement Gerard Hoyata. There's the man with the distinctive bush of hair. Halaili via Hamami. This is Mazgar. Again, a bit too much in isolation, but that's a very well-judged floated ball. Is that high by Hunt? Play on, says the referee. No offence. Zegden, last player of the game. Zegden sets up, and Ben Hamida,
stay back.
One of the quite large number of Tunisian players who play their club rugby in France. Keep your eye on the ball, is the message. There's the final play, a knock on by Hassouna, and, well, New Zealand were always in control from